Let's begin with all the latest updates coming in on Prime Minister Modi's visit to Russia. We're getting you exclusive details now of the Modi-Putin gala dinner that everyone's watching out for. The Russian President Vladimir Putin will be hosting Prime Minister Modi at his Moscow cottage. There's a one-on-one dinner that will essentially set the tone for the bilateral as well. It's going to be a private affair, a private dinner that's going to last for about 2 hours. And it shows the importance being accorded to the trip being made by Prime Minister Modi. And the fact he's chosen Russia to be his first state visit. A guard of honor has already been lined up for Prime Minister Modi when he touches down in Moscow, which is expected to be at about 5:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. So a high-level reception awaits Modi in Russia. There's going to be a bit of a desi flavor also in the welcome, as Russian artists will be performing Garba at the hotel where the Prime Minister will be staying in Moscow. Okay, these are the details that we're picking up right now. There will be a guard of honor accorded to Prime Minister Modi once he touches down in Moscow. From there, he's going to be headed to the hotel in Moscow, and there too, a grand performance is lined up tonight at about 9:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time is when the private dinner will take place, where President Putin will play host to Prime Minister Modi. And Narendra Modi's Russia visit kicks off today, an extremely important state visit. Prime Minister Modi left for Moscow at about 11 a.m. Indian Standard Time. This is Prime Minister Modi's first visit to Russia after the Russia-Ukraine conflict broke out. Prime Minister Modi will land in Moscow at about 5:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. And after that, will be headed to the private dinner with Russian President Vladimir Putin, which Putin, in fact, is hosting in his cottage. The Prime Minister is also going to be visiting the tomb of the unknown soldier in Kremlin, where he will be laying a wreath to pay a tribute to all the fallen soldiers of Russia. Now, the meet between Prime Minister Modi and Putin will be extremely significant because it will focus, of course, on bilateral ties between the two nations and strengthening that. Both leaders will also discuss global security. And we will get in also Gaurav Sawant to join us in just a bit from Moscow to get you all the details that we're picking up right now of the Prime Minister's schedule going forward. And also the details that we have highlights the importance that this particular visit is being given by Russia as well. Russian President Vladimir Putin will be hosting Prime Minister Modi at his cottage, at his personal cottage. And that really tells you how much importance Putin is giving to this particular meeting. The fact that the Russian president has spoken constantly about his personal friendship with Prime Minister Modi being reflected in the fact that he's hosting this dinner at his cottage. That's going to be happening tonight, and then tomorrow is the all-important bilateral as well. But tonight's dinner, which is expected to happen at about 9:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time, will be a private affair. There will be no media, there will be no interactions whatsoever. It will be essentially Prime Minister Modi and President Putin sitting together at one table to discuss several global affairs. And that tells you the importance that Russia is giving to an ally like India, knowing full well the role India plays in global affairs at a time, of course, that we're seeing that conflict with Ukraine as well. Gaurav Sawant is joining us live from Moscow with more details on this. Gaurav, details that you've been able to pick up really of the special welcome being accorded to Prime Minister Modi. As expected, there will be a grand guard of honor at the airport, a bit of desi welcome really at the hotel where he will be in Moscow. But very importantly, the spotlight will be on that private dinner, which we're told President Putin will be hosting in his cottage.
So Kremlin is literally laying out the red carpet for Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He will arrive here in a short while from now. You're absolutely right. There's a huge guard of honor and a very high profile reception at the airport itself as the Prime Minister lands and then drives to where we are. That's the Kremlin right behind me. With me is Zinia Kondrateva. She's a senior journalist and analyst here in Moscow, is reporting from the Kremlin. And just behind us is also Prime Minister Narendra Modi's hotel, where he's staying, and that's where you have the Indian diaspora who've started assembling in numbers already. But I want to begin by getting you a perspective from the Russian side on this visit. And Xenia Kondrateva, you know, we've been interacting with you as Russian special operations have continued in Ukraine. In midst of that, this is the first visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, first bilateral in his third tenure. How's Kremlin viewing this? How's Russia viewing this?
I think Moscow is giving high importance to this visit, and there is a lot of appreciation that this is the first bilateral visit in his third term that just began last month. It is important that, it is the first meeting in 3 years because Mr. Putin went to Delhi in 2021. Then they briefly met in Samarkand, where we know what Prime Minister Modi has told Mr. Putin. Again, I don't think that is a criticism, like a lot of the Western media at that time saw it. It's to give out the perspective of the Global South, not just India, because India now more and more represents the Global South that has had an impact, you know, of this conflict. Because
so for the benefit of viewers, when they met in Uzbekistan on the sidelines of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had said this is not an era of war. And the Western media took it as Indian criticism of Russian operations. But that it wasn't criticism of Russian operations. That's not the way Russia views it. They're looking at more how the world, the Global South, is being impacted by paucity of fuel and fertilizer.
I think there has been no discontent between New Delhi and Moscow about how both countries see each other foreign policy and what's happening globally. What is important here is that India delivered its perspective, and since then leaders have been maintaining contacts. Of course, it is important to meet personally because there are a lot of issues that are to be discussed, from geopolitics, because not only Ukraine is affecting the world today. We have crisis in the Middle East, which is affecting India and the Global South as much. There are practical issues that Russia and India have. See, the relationship in the past 2 years have taken up a lot, especially economic relationship, because of energy trade, because of other trade that is probably a bit less in the public.
So but let's get down to numbers. Bilateral trade between India and Russia, it's really grown $65 billion, but $60 billion in Russia's favor, $5 billion is India's trade with Russia approximately. Can that trade be addressed, that imbalance be addressed? What's your understanding from your conversations in Kremlin?
It's not easy, and both countries have been trying to diversify. Again, as I said, there are projects that are happening not related to energy trade, but let me speak honestly, both countries are keeping a lower profile because we know that there are Western sanctions on Russia. Indian government and businesses are being pressurized by the Western partners who are using these sanctions as a completely unjust kind of a competition tool. So there is a lot happening, but it's difficult. You have to solve logistical problems, you have to solve banking problems, and these are those practical questions which I hope will also be taken by the leaders.
So what's on the agenda, from what you've been able to understand? We are told that there's a dinner at the president's dacha, his home on the outskirts of Moscow, and that's a personal touch that will set the tone for this meeting that happens tomorrow. So 26 hours that Prime Minister Narendra Modi spends here. What is Moscow expecting?
I think it's important to understand India's perspective. We are 3 years, almost 3 years into the conflict. I'm sure that Moscow and Delhi have a good understanding of each other's perspective, but again, since they have an opportunity to speak in person, and Mr. Modi just went for a G7 meeting, I've been reading a lot, including in the Indian media, that Mr. Modi will be sort of delivering messages from the West to. I don't really think that's necessary. I think the messages are clear. How India and Russia are going to act in their own interest is much more important than.
Do we expect more on defense? Do we expect more on trade? Do we expect more on connectivity, whether it's the Vladivostok-Chennai corridor, the Arctic cooperation? Where do you see the key takeaway from this visit?
I wouldn't want to speculate on that because we know as much as, you know, we media get all the statements. But I think payments is something that is affecting both businesses. Logistics has been already taken up. A lot of work has been done in the past 2 years, both on INCTC route, the north-south corridor via Iran, and India just signed a big agreement again to the sadness of the West. India
has a big smile to India's face, as I noticed.
Yeah, because
that.
Whatever our countries do kind of is an arc to the West. It shouldn't be that way because we are a big world where all roots, all kind of relationship have to be there, you know. Okay. It's not one-sided.
There is one issue that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is expected to take up, and that is those Indians who were apparently misled into joining that war, and they're fighting right now in Ukraine, for Russian mercenaries. Two of them have apparently lost their lives, we are told, and that list is anything between 40 and 50 is the number?
I've only heard the numbers from the Indian side. From the Russian side, we've got the statement that they are in touch with the Indian authorities, and I guess they are working on it. But it's important that it's a big, again, what we know from the Indian media, it's a trafficking network. So they are not getting there willingly. They're misled into the conflict. So I'm sure that this issue will be taken up. And I think a lot of it is already resolved.
Okay. So a lot of it is already resolved, is Xenia Kondrateva's understanding. India is very clear. So who are these people? Apparently, they were victims of human trafficking, trying to get into Europe. They were brought in here and from here pushed into fighting that conflict in Ukraine. There have been two losses of lives. India's effort is also to ensure that those bodies are recovered and repatriated to their homes. Apparently, okay. Two from Punjab.
Thanks very much for getting us those updates from Moscow. Gaurav, in conversation also with Sidia there, who gave us a sense of what really to expect from that crucial meeting between Prime Minister Modi and President Putin. But let's get you some of the inputs that Gaurav has been filing for us over the last few hours.
Well, there were a lot of other issues I touched upon, but I don't want to preempt, sort of this, because, as you know, Prime Minister Modi is going to Moscow next week. In fact, yesterday evening, President Putin mentioned to me that he's looking forward very much to that visit. So I think preparations are underway. Obviously, our discussions contributed to it. But what will come out, you will have to wait till the visit is.
What do we expect from this visit? Because if we were to talk about the traditional strategic ties between India and Russia, whether it's from the 1950s or the pact in 1971 or the Kargil conflict, Russia's always been a close friend of India. But now, in the field of critical technologies, in the field of defense, new technologies, how is this relationship being taken forward, co-production, co-manufacturing, or the issue of space?
Today, India-Russia ties are characterized by a special and privileged strategic partnership. That defines the contours of our cooperation and our interaction across a large number of issues and areas of mutual interest. Defense is, of course, an important part. We are doing co-production of a number of defense items. But also, our relations have expanded in trade and investments. There are Indian investments in Russian energy sector. There are Russian investments in India, in energy, in railways, in defense production. I mentioned also steel. These relations are expanding in trade and economic fields. We also have very close cooperation in scientific field, joint work between a number of Indian and Russian institutions. We have very active collaboration in cultural and academic educational fields. We have close people-to-people ties. So as I said, the overall framework for these multifaceted relationship today is the annual summit between the two leaders and the special and privileged strategic partnership that we have.
भारतीय समुदाय को क्या उम्मीद है प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी से, क्योंकि वो भारतीय समुदाय को भी यहाँ संबोधित करेंगे?
देखिए, हम लोगों को बहुत उम्मीद है। सबसे बड़ी है जो हमारी जो आह्वाना थी कि प्रधानमंत्री जी और पुतिन जी बैठ करके कम से कम रूपी रूबल ट्रेड पर एक बार बात करें, क्योंकि इसके बगैर जो है हमारा ट्रेड जो है रुका हुआ है। उसके बगैर कोई अच्छी तरीके से जो हम आगे कर सकते हैं, जो बड़े ट्रेड को बढ़ा सकते हैं, वो नहीं हो पा रहा है। और ये मुद्दा काफ़ी दिनों से बढ़ता चला जा रहा है। मेरे ख्याल से केवल मोदी जी और पुतिन इसको सॉल्व कर सकते हैं। अगर ये हो जाता है तो हमारा जो कल्चर भी बढ़ेगा, बिजनेस बढ़ेगी और सारी चीज़ें उसके साथ साथ चलेंगी, क्योंकि रूपी रूबल ट्रेड जरूरी है।
I'm very proud of it because I'm a yoga teacher and it's connecting dancing, yoga, and when I can do something for make a responsible for the Indian people, for the Indian country, for me it's like I'm honored.
We are going to perform in front of Prime Minister, and it's a big honor for us, and we are going to perform our dance which called Paripahi. We are going to perform, and we are really exciting about it, and we are waiting for applause and support from audience.
I'm learning Kathak dance for maybe 7 years, and I'm happy that finally I can present this beautiful, my favorite art form in front of Narendra Modi, and I'm happy that this event is happening, that Narendra Modi is visiting Moscow, and it means that relationship between two my beloved countries are really strong.
बहुत खुश है हमारे PM जी यहाँ पे आ रहे हैं, विजिट है उनकी, तो हम सब लोग बहुत एक्साइटेड है। उसके लिए हमने प्रिपरेशन भी बहुत अच्छी की। हमारे सब रशियन जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं वो भी काफ़ी मेहनत करते हैं डांस में, वो डांस सीखा उन्होंने, तो हमने अभी शिव स्तुति सिखाई इनको, शिव स्तोत्रम सिखाया इनको, तो उस पर हम लोग मोदी जी के सामने अपने परफॉर्मेंस